जयो राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी, जयो राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी, जय गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावन चारी, जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी, जयो राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा रामा राम हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा रामा राम हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा रामा राम हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम हरे हरे। जय राधा श्याम सुंदर, राधा श्याम सुंदर राधे राधे, जय राधा श्याम सुंदर, राधा श्याम सुंदर राधे राधे। जय कृष्णा बलराम कृष्ण बलराम, जय कृष्णा बलराम जनिताई गौरांग, जय निताई गौरांग निताई गौरांग, जय निताई गौरांग, जय जय प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद, जय जय प्रभुपाद, जय जय प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद, जय जय प्रभुपाद, जय जय गुरुदेव गुरुदेव गुरुदेव, जय जय गुरुदेव, जय जय गुरुदेव गुरुदेव गुरुदेव, जय जय गुरुदेव। पिता इंद्र और प्रेमानंद रिपोर्ट। सो टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम वर्स 38 चैप्टर 6 ध्यान योगा। काचिनो भय विभ्रष्टाश्चिन्ना भ्रमिव नश्यति, आप्रतिष्ठो महाबाहो विमूढो ब्रह्मणपथि। काचिनो भय विभ्रष्टाश्चिन्ना भ्रमिव नश्यति, आप्रतिष्ठो महाबाहो विमूढो ब्रह्मणपथि। कश्चिनो भय विभ्रष्ट छिन्ना भ्रमिव नश्यति, आप्रतिष्ठो महाबाहो विमूढो ब्रह्मणपथि। वर्ड टू वर्ड ट्रांसलेशन। कच वेदर ना नॉट उभया बोध विभ्रष्ट डिवास्टेड फ्रॉम चिन्ना टॉन Abraham cloud, Eva like, Nasyati perishes, Apratish without any position, Mahabaho, O mighty armed Krishna, Vimudaha, bewildered, Brahmanaha, O transcendence, Pati, on the path. Translation, O mighty armed Krishna, does not such a man who is bewildered from the path of transcendence fall away from both spiritual and material success and perish like a raven cloud with no position in any sphere? Purport, by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. There are two ways to progress. Those who are materialist have no interest in transcendence. Therefore, they are more interested in material advancement by economic development or in promotion to the higher planets by appropriate work. When one takes to the path of transcendence, one has to cease all material activities and sacrifice all form of so-called material happiness. If the aspiring transcendentalist fails, then he apparently loses both ways. In other words, he can enjoy neither material happiness nor spiritual success. He has no position. He is like a raven cloud. A cloud in the sky sometimes deviates from a small cloud and joins a big one. But if it cannot join a big one, then it is blown away by the wind and becomes a non-entity in the vast sky. The Brahmana Pati is the path of transcendental realization through knowing oneself to the spiritual in essence, part and partial of Supreme Lord, who is manifested as Brahmana, Paramatma, and Bhagwan. Lord Shri Krishna in the fullest manifestation of the absolute truth, and therefore, one who is surrendered to the Supreme Person is a successful transcendentalist. To reach this goal of life through Brahman and Paramatma realization takes many, many births. Bahuna Janmanam Ante. Therefore, the supermost path of transcendental realization is Bhakti Yoga or Krishna consciousness, the direct method. Om Jnanam Timiran Dasya Jnanam Jalashalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Nama Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Utpad Kamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahakan Raghunathan Vitam Sajivam Savadetam Savadutan Parijan Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha कृष्ण पादान सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितं च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी श्री राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतित नाम पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम रामा हरे हरे। सो टुडेस वर्स इज अ ब्यूटिफुल इंक्वायरी फ्रॉम Arjuna to Lord Shri Krishna. Actually, this shloka is connected to shloka 37 of chapter 6 itself, because the inquiry itself started by Arjuna in verse 37, and he is continuing in this verse itself. He is asking what a man will have his destiny, one who loses his path of spirituality when he is not able to reach the ultimate goal. So Krishna will give a beautiful answer, but this is an inquiry for all of us also. Sometimes we may think also that because of my circumstances, because of my condition surrounding, I am not able to pick up Krishna consciousness to the fullest. But whatever small I am doing, will this get wasted? Whatever services I have done to the Lord and to His devotees, will it get wasted? If I am in this current situation, somehow not able to pursue it as in the same level as earlier. So the inquiry of Arjuna is also for all of us to get into the knowledge that the path of spirituality is the one which never perishes. Whatever we have earned in this path through our bhajan kriya, through our sadhana, going to get with us life after life. What to talk about perishing in this life itself? It's been mentioned so many places in Srimad Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam that if you study spirituality from A to B, B to C, and C to D, and you leave your body, or you may not able to continue because of your health and whatsoever concern, but you have studied spirituality up to D, so when you will take next birth, you will continue your spiritual life from D onwards. So you have to study E, F. You have not to start with A, B, C. This is the beauty of spirituality. And not only continuing is one of the benefit, but also whatever we have done, Krishna will never forget that. Whatever small, whatever big, one's contribution is towards spirituality, Supreme Personality of Godhead. So when we talk about Krishna, as we are hankering as devotee, if we are hankering to achieve Krishna, same way Krishna is also hankering to get all these living and suffering and entities back to Himself, to get connected with Him. So Krishna's hankering and devotees as individuals or hankering is Krishna's is more hankering to get us back to Him. So He's making all arrangement for us to get connected to good devotees, to start reading Bhagavad Gita. We get chance, we get n number of chance to get into spirituality, to inquire, to get the answer of our unanswered questions and proceed further in the journey of spirituality. But we should not take it like the least concerned thing or the last thing in our wish list. Spirituality should be the topmost thing because there is no loss. In verse 40, Krishna will answer, chapter 6, verse 40, Krishna will answer that there will be no loss. Whoever getting connected with me, there will be no loss to him, whether he is able to continue or he left in the middle. So we can say in short, this is a path of all profitability. There is no loss at all. So who will not join into the work or into a field where there is just a profitability? When we start some business or some kind of startups are there, we always calculate what will be the loss, what will be the profit, what is the ratio of taking all risk, and this much risk will give me this much profit. So here in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Krishna will ensure that there will be no loss. There is just profitability. So we should jump into it, take benefit out of it, and also spread it to others. Like this, Bhakti Yoga is the very easiest way. Here Srila Prabhupada has explained in last line, therefore the supermost path of transcendental realization is Bhakti Yoga. There are different methods to achieve the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Dhyana Yoga is one of the way. Jnana Yoga is one of the way. But out of all these ways, Bhakti Yoga is the easiest one because you need not to get out of your way. You need not to leave your family. You need not to leave your work. Rather, you can take up this along with your family responsibility. Bhakti Yoga is the most easiest one. This month, we are celebrating our Bhagavad Gita marathon. So, Bhagavad Gita is where Krishna has given all this transcendental knowledge to Arjuna. And through Arjuna, we all are getting benefits. So we should try to promote, distribute more and more Bhagavad Gita. There are a few wonderful stories available in how Bhagavad Gita is so powerful. It's been said that Bhagavad Gita is so powerful, even just hearing Bhagavad Gita, just touching Bhagavad Gita, just seeing Bhagavad Gita purifies one's very identity. The person gets elevated. So we should also try to distribute more and more knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, and we should try to distribute more and more of Bhagavad Gita. There is a wonderful story I would like to share. There was a sage who used to travel from one place to another place, and he used to read all verses of Srimad Bhagavad Gita staying in one particular village. When he used to stay in that particular village, all village people, rich and poor, used to gather at one place. And that sage used to recite shlokas of Bhagavad Gita, and they used to spend all good time with them and used to learn few practical things which they used to really apply in their day-to-day life, because they were mostly farmers and poor people, even though some of the big landlords also used to join the sage. So the disciples also used to travel. One day they reached one village, and he saw that my Guru Maharaj, the sage, is giving daily discourse of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, but nearly no one was coming. And then he thought a trick. He thought, I will call everybody today, and I will say today is a special day, and I will hand them over a few Bhagavad Gitas. And I will keep 500 rupee note in between of Bhagavad Gita. Then I will see how they're gonna react. Some of the people, those who were coming off and on, when they heard today is a special class day, something special will be there. So majority of people used to come on regular basis were very less, but that day few more joined. So there were a few books of Bhagavad Gita with 500 rupee note inside. And disciple was somewhere outside when the discourse was going on. And when he returned back, he checked all Bhagavad Gitas, and all 500 rupee notes were inside it. And no one took any money out of Bhagavad Gita. So he just got very frustrated, and he thought, I think even after announcement and even after keeping a 500 rupee note, I think nobody turned up today itself. What a shame. And out of furious mood, he reached to his Guru Maharaj and said all wrong thing about the village and village people, and said very few used to come, but I guess today nobody turned up. So the Guru Maharaj asked, the sage asked, how you know that nobody turned up today? So he said, because in all Bhagavad Gita, I have kept individual notes, and that money is still intact therein. So the sage got angry, and he said, you fool. Even after hearing Bhagavad Gita with me, traveling from one village to another, associating with me, you haven't understand the glories of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Whosoever gets in touch with, sees Bhagavad Gita, gets purified. There were few present today. Even today they were here. When you were gone outside, they were here present, and they have opened Bhagavad Gita and they have read with me. Yes, number are very less. They are not many in numbers, but they were present. But out of the association of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, they haven't taken the money with them. They again closed the book and kept it back there. So, with this we can understand. We may think money is the driving force, but actually spirituality, Krishna is the driving force. Srimad Bhagavad Gita is the driving force. One person can be illiterate one. He may not be a big scholar. He may not be a rich person. But if he is having faith, little faith, then also he can achieve the ultimate purpose of life. He can go beyond all knowledgeable people, all gyanis. So bhakti yoga is this way. An association of Srimad Bhagavad Gita works in this way. So bhakti yoga takes you away from all these clutches where one gets entangled in one thing and thinks that this is the only thing of one's life, just to have money, just to have a happy family. Even though things get baffled sooner or later in this material, this is the nature of this material world, that everything is temporary. Dukhalyam ashashvatam. So everything is going to get changed sooner or later. So the understanding from this story is like Krishna, his name, form, sound, vibrations are all non-different. And Bhagavad Gita, which was spoken by Lord Shri Krishna to Arjuna, is also non-different from Krishna himself. So when we are taking Bhagavad Gita as a source of inspiration, as a source of understanding to one's life, as a manual to mankind, as a guiding book to mankind, it really changes us. Not 100%, not 80%, not 60% maybe, but maybe we can really try to get change as much as one can, depending upon one's circumstances. Desh kal patra. One can always pick up Srimad Bhagavad Gita and read something best out of it. It's nothing that difficult, what we think. So here in Bhagavad Gita, Shloka 37 and 38 and 39 is all inquiry done by Arjuna, which is really very nice to understand, that even the one who is associating with the Lord is asking all questions. So questions are good actually. Because when you have questions, it means that you are actually onto the path of understanding something, onto the path of really, practically you are just trying to get into it rather than just hearing it, sitting it years after years and you're not getting out of it. It means when you have questions, like Arjuna is asking questions, so we should also ask questions to our seniors, to our guru, so that we can practically understand each and every verse and try to get all these things in our life and inculcate good habits, as been mentioned by Srila Prabhupada and previous acharyas. So one who is doing all good here, the one who has got bewildered from the path of transcendent, where will he go? That is the question. So Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2nd, verse 40, Krishna is giving this beautiful verse. Neha bhikrama nasho asti pratyavayo na vidyate swalpam apasya dharmase trayate mahato bhayat. In this, Krishna is telling in Bhagavad Gita, this shloka where he is telling, the Supreme Personality of Godhead said, son of Pratha, a transcendentalist engaged in the auspicious activities, does not meet with any kind of destruction either in this world or after. So whatever little achievement is being done by a transcendentalist, it's never going vain. It's been said by Krishna himself in chapter 2nd, verse 40. So a person who is doing good will never meet anything bad. It may take time. It may take some... it's not that instant, actually. It can be instant, but it depends upon our way of taking it up, our sincerity. It depends upon how much we are actually believing it, how much we are actually thriving for it. Rather, we are just taking verbally and not changing as per been mentioned. So, if you proceed one step toward Krishna, you will be fixed up there. Then you have to take another step. You can take up all these steps in one lifetime, or you keep on taking one step at each life, depending upon us. So we should act intelligently. When Krishna is promising so many things to us in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, he is promising all happiness, he is promising all success, he is promising whatever is there with my devotee, I protect that. And whichever thing he's lacking, whatever things lacking, I am going to provide them all to him. So these are the promises, and many more are done by the Lord to all of us. So why should we then hesitate? Here, Arjuna is asking, what will happen? Nothing will happen. The person will be in a good state, rather than a person who is not picking up spirituality at all. He is not going to lose anything anywhere. That is for sure. He is not going to be a loser in spiritual world. He is not going to be a loser in material world. Why? Because Krishna is protecting everything. That is rest assured. Here also, when we do something new, we want assurance from people with whom we are working. There is always a new person who starts something. He seeks the blessings and the guidance of the elderlies or the one who are already into that field. That is a very common phenomena everywhere. You have to, you want some kind of assurance. If I pick up this business, if I pick up this studies, what I'm gonna be like after 5 years down the line? So what is the answer for that? The answer is, it depends upon your hard work. The success depends upon your hard work, your dedication, and your surrender. In material world also, same way in spiritual world also. But in spiritual world, Krishna is taking care of us without any jealousy, without any kind of contamination. Because in material world, even the rakshak gets into the zone of bhakshak. The one who was providing us all protection is actually tries to destroy us. That is a material nature. Because out of money, out of position, people try to really suppress others. They don't want others to get up to their position. And this fear also leads them to do all this nonsense. So material world is really very pathetic place. You cannot trust people like so easily. But in material, in spiritual world, when Krishna is giving assurance, where all previous acharyas, where Srila Prabhupada is also leading us, all Guru Maharaj are leading us toward the path of spirituality. So it means this is a safe and secure path. So there is no loss. There is no loss. You will get the benefit of your whatever karmas you have done in your past life. You will get everything in this present life, as per money is concerned, as per whatever basic facilities are concerned. If you are destined to get it, you will get it. Because you have done that kind of karmas in your past life, that you will get what you will get what you have done. If you have done really good in your last birth, so you will get all these things very easily. Money will be easy for you. Taking a house will be easy for you. Maintaining yourself, maintaining your basic necessities will not be a big trouble for you. Then what should you do? This means that you have done something good in your past. So continue doing good, and taking up spirituality, taking up Krishna consciousness is one of the best thing one can ever do. In chapter 7 also, Krishna will talk about those who are born with good, opulent everything surrounding money, house and everything. They should take up the path of spirituality. They must take up. Why so? Because they are not just about earning their bread and butter. They have not to do that hard work. So they take up something more exalted, the ultimate purpose for what the human birth is given. They should take up from a very early age. These are the signs. When you have association of devotees from your childhood, when you have basic necessities actually get fulfilled, it's not like you have to run for each and everything, have to earn your bread and butter. Your house will not, your people will not survive, your household things will not move. If you will not work day and night, if this kind of situation is not there, so you are lucky enough. Just take up to the path of spirituality, because you have been blessed by all these good karmas into your last. The same way, the karmic things will happen the way it is. The bad will be decreased by the Lord's blessings, the blessings of the Vaishnavas. All the bad things will be reduced. It will not be get nullified, but somehow or the other, it will get a less impact on you because you are getting closer and closer to Krishna. So the impact will be less, but if we really got surrendered, like the acharyas or the great devotees, then even Krishna can nullify the fruit of action. Those who are not bearing the fruit, it's like it's been mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam also. There are karmas which are sprouted. You have to taste them, whether good or bad. But those who are under the earth and not sprouted yet can be waved off by Krishna altogether for forever. So when you talk about spirituality, it's a way of life. It's a good way of life. Bhakti yoga is one of the easiest way to understand why you are here. What is the purpose? I have taken birth. Where I'm heading? So these all questions get answered. Along with that, you also get a good heart. That is very important. The moral values, if you talk on the lighter note of students in school and institution, they teach them moral education, they teach them moral values. Bhagavad Gita is full of all these things. How you have to, when you are in a particular situation and you want to act. So you have all these stories in Srimad Bhagavatam and in Bhagavad Gita where you understand what you have to do when you are in a particular situation. So anger is one of the difficult things nowadays. Anger, lust, greed. So here in Bhagavad Gita, so many times Krishna has mentioned you have to come above that. I'll share a small story about a father and a son about how anger can be so detrimental. The loved one becomes the biggest enemy sometimes. This is the impact of Kali Yuga. Anger is very easily provocable here. Lust is very easily provocable here. Then how to come? Greed is very easily provocable. Then how to get out of all these things? With the help of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you can be under control, you can be under check. It takes sometimes years and years to really get into the zone of Srimad Bhagavad Gita where you really act like a real devotee. So I'll share a story. Once there was a man who was having a small 4-year-old child, and he was a loving father to the child, and he used to carry child wherever he used to go. And after some time, he bought a car, and he was also in love with a new polished sophisticated car. So one day the child was playing near the car, and the father was singing and polishing his car. So this small child started scratching something on the car through some stone or pebble he took from the garden itself. And he was just scratching on the car. Father just saw it and he got so angry, and he was just like a different person altogether. And he started, he took the hand of the child and started hitting the hand of a 4-year-old child with a stick. He did it several times, and out of anger, he didn't realize this child is so young to get that kind of punishment for just scratching the car. Then after some time, he came into his senses. He took him to the hospital, and the child lost all his 4 fingers where he was beaten by the father with a stick. And when the father entered into that operation theater, and child asked very, very sweetly but with fearful eyes, "Father, will my fingers will grow back again? I'm gonna get my fingers. Will they grow back again?" And it was very difficult for him to answer because he has really lost all 4 fingers out of the anger of the father just scratching the car. So it's a very pathetic story, but a truth nowadays. Your loved one gets so angry on you because the love is so temporary here. That is the most important point. The love here in material world is so temporary. And the story continues. The person went back to his home and he saw his car. He hit the car tire several times with his leg out of pain for his own child. He was crying and he just went toward the side where the child scratched with the stone. And he saw the child has written, "I love you, Dad." So he was in tears. But then out of fit of anger, his son is going to suffer all his life. So all these things leads us toward Krishna, that if you really wanted to have relationship with somebody eternally, you should be in love with Krishna. You should try to surrender to Krishna. You should try to have a mother-son relationship with Krishna. We have to fulfill all our duties, but let them to be onto the platform of duties only. Don't get absorbed. Don't get just go away with these things. Everyone is here present in your life for some purpose, to give you something or to take something from you, or they can be a part of your life journey. But you have to always remember one thing: your life belongs to Krishna. This is what Bhagavad Gita is teaching us. So we have to associate to understand the real worth of one's life, rather than just wasting your life spending time here and there, making all good arrangement of one's lifestyle may get changed very often. So it's a ever-changing world where you can't guarantee anything for a long time. But one thing you can guarantee is Krishna. So those who are associated with Krishna are long-lasting mostly. Those who are following the path of spirituality are the most fortunate one, because they are leading their life toward truthfulness. Actually, they know one truth of life, that is Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is one of the biggest truth. Even half of the world don't know that. You ask people, who is God? They will give you n number of names. Who is Supreme Personality of Godhead? They will give you n number of names. We must respect each and every demigod, Devi Devta. We must. But then we should also know the ultimate person. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is one without a second. Krishna is the only one, and we should surrender unto the one who is all powerful, the one who is all loving. So this shloka is really very, every shloka of Srimad Bhagavad Gita is actually wonderful in itself, because it's teaching you a lot. Every individual soul gets enchanted by one shloka or the another. Bhagavad Gita, whenever I used to read it earlier also, even today also, it's been so many years. Whenever I read each and every shloka, I'd say, oh wow, it's such a great shloka. One life is really very less to understand all this Guhyatam Gyan. Srila Prabhupada has mentioned in all his books that this is the knowledge which is easily available, but then also it is not available. In the sense, you can get a book, or you can hear a lecture, but it depends on you how much you surrender onto it. If you are really surrendered to Srimad Bhagavad Gita, if you are really surrendered to your Guru Maharaj, to Srila Prabhupada, you are really fortunate one. Otherwise, it's just a kind of involvement on the name of spirituality. So this Guhyatam Gyan only comes through Acharyas, those who are really connected with the Lord. They can only give you something. A blind man can never give you a right way, because he even don't know where to lead himself. Those who are really following the path, those who are really are being enlightened by this knowledge, can only enlighten you. So Srila Prabhupada is one of the gurus which we are following the movement of Srila Prabhupada. He is leading us, all of us, on a very easy path of spirituality by Bhakti Yoga. We should all follow the instructions of Srila Prabhupada. We should read Srimad Bhagavad Gita. We should chant our daily rounds and try to imbibe, use all these shlokas in our day-to-day life. And here in the purport, Srila Prabhupada has mentioned Krishna, the Brahman Pati is a path of transcendental realization through knowing oneself to be spiritual in essence, part and partial of Supreme Lord, who is manifested as Brahman, Paramatma and Bhagwan. This has been mentioned so many times in Srimad Bhagavad Gita that we all are part and partial of Krishna. When you start loving Krishna, you start loving everyone, respecting everyone, because when you start seeing Krishna in each and every individual, the understanding of the Supreme Personality of Godhead comes from Brahman to Paramatma and to Bhagwan. And here we are talking about Bhagwan Shri Krishna. Understanding Bhagwan Shri Krishna is the ultimate goal and ultimate understanding of all spiritual knowledge. Here also, wherever you talk about Krishna, wherever you sit and chant the holy name, wherever you get congregational chanting, the place becomes so pure. This is the power of Krishna's name. You sit just any place, that place will become full of energy. That place will become purified because Krishna is present there in his name form. In Padma Purana, there is a beautiful shloka where it's been said, Naham tishtanti vaikunthe yoginam hridayeshu va tatra tishthami narada yatra gayanti mad bhakta. Here, Lord is saying, O Narada, I am not in Vaikuntha, nor am I in the heart of the yogis. I remain where my devotees glorify my name, form, qualities, and transcendental pastimes. So, he is not residing in the Vaikuntha. He is not even sitting in the heart of the yogis. He is sitting where we all are chanting, where we all are hearing about him, where we all are talking about him. Everybody should get attracted to Krishna because he is the most attractive one. He is so beautiful. He is so full of compassion. He is so full of love that everyone gets attracted to him. And that is why he's doing so many pastimes, because he knows every individual gets attracted to different qualities. So these are the few verses which we really get into the form of understanding that Krishna is the ultimate source of energy, who is manifesting all this cosmic manifestation, and he is the ultimate purpose of one's very life. And whosoever is following this path will never fail, will never get any kind of loss. There is just one thing we get in here, and that is all profit, because we are associating with Krishna, who is Lakshmipati, who is the Aradhya of Srimati Radharani. How one can get any loss onto this path? Because this is the path of all success. This is the path of all happiness. This is the path of love, compassion, and surrender. So there is no loss. We are associating with Krishna. We are very fortunate. So we should continue our journey. Always pray to Srila Prabhupada and to our Guru Maharaj that we, wherever we shall be, we should always try to move further. Hare Krishna. I stop here. Any question or comment?
Any questions or comments, you can unmute right on the chat. Hare Krishna, Prabhu. No, he's muted again. You want to ask a question, Prabhu? No, I think there was an accident. Okay, thank you very much.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.